Hi, if you have reached thus far, you have been introduced to the various terms in the final accounts of the companies, and you should be very well familiar with the contents in the balance sheet and the income statement. In this video, I'm going to help you validate the learning that we've had till now. By validation, I mean to say that I have helped you prepare the balance sheet and income statement in the account format. However, the statements in the annual report of a company look different. They are typically presented in the statement format, not the account format. So in this video, I'm going to tell you that the statement format is nothing but a better presentation of the account format. An account format gives us more breakdowns, more information, more data to be converted into information. So we are going to look at the balance sheet of Reliance Industries Limited again and look at its content. And while you look at the content, I'll take you through the notes as well. And you will see that the concepts that we discussed in last, many videos are actually followed by these companies. So let's get started. So I have on the screen the balance sheet. The asset side of the balance sheet for Reliance Industries Limited. And you are no stranger to this balance sheet because we've seen this at the beginning of the course as well. So in this balance sheet, we're going to look through some selected items and then we are going to relate the balances or the data which has been provided here to our learnings in the last few videos relating to the final accounts. So on the asset side, we said there are two heads, non-current assets and current assets. So it appears as it is. And we have within non-current assets, property, plant and equipment and details are provided in note one. Notice that in the final accounts that we prepared, we showed the name of the asset and we showed the total amount and we deducted the depreciation out of it. Here in this balance sheet, you have been given the final value of property, plant, and equipment, and all the assets have been clubbed into one head. All fixed assets, property, plant, and equipment, everything has been clubbed under it. So we can just go to note number one, and I have it ready with me. And in the note number one, if you recall, this is the gross block, which is the cost of the asset. And this is the section that you should consider as the value that we showed in the balance sheet. And out of this value, we deducted depreciation amount. So you take out all the depreciation and then you have the net block. The word block only means the balance, the clubbing all the value of all the assets. You call that a block. So this is exactly what is done, except that it is more complicated in a company format. And what we did was more simplistic so that you could grasp the concepts gradually at a smaller scale. In a company like Reliance, which is the largest in India, you will have many complex transactions. But the idea is if you understand the basic, you know the principles, now you can look into more details. You can further do research on what is amortization, what is depletion, and why do they have three columns within it. So all of this is only a functional knowledge. The technical knowledge you already have. You know the principle is that from the cost, you have to deduct depreciation and show the final value in the balance sheet. And rest can be figured out on your own. So this is one. The other example that I want to show is 0.7. So points, note number seven is for trade receivables. We've discussed that you have debtors and you adjust them for any bad debts and so on. Do companies actually do that? So let's look at note seven, which I also have here. So trade receivables, these are the debtors. These are the customers from whom you have to recover the money. All of these are unsecured, meaning, if they don't pay, you can't do anything about it. You don't have any security against it. And all are considered good. What does it mean? That means there are no bad debts. So the companies do take a note. And, possibly if you stumble upon some other companies' balance sheets, you may find that they have some bad debts. They may specify it. In Reliance Industries' case, they are stating that we are considering all our receivables as good. None of those are going to be bad. And therefore, they have their, you know, amount here. So we did this as well earlier when we were doing the practice questions and tutorials. We adjusted the debtor's amount for bad debts, and companies actually in practice do that. Then I have another note on inventories. Let me go back to balance sheet. You have inventories. What is this inventory? This is the stock. This is this unsold stock. This is the closing stock. All right. So are we alone in, you know, discussing the closing stock? No. Companies actually have to show their closing stock. And note number five. Let me go to note number five here. So this is the stock as at 31st March 2019, which is the end of the financial year. So this is the closing stock. Now the stock here has different categories. So this is a complex business, different types of stocks, stock of raw material, stock of material which is being converted. So it's a work in progress, stock of finished goods, spare parts, stock in trade. So different kinds of stocks are there. Now the question is, you know, how do we distinguish between these, and which is something which can be easily learned by doing more research. But you know the principle on which this categorization is based. You know what is closing stock, why is it shown where it is shown, and so on. So that is inventories for you. And then I want to take you to note number 10. Note number 10, which is for other financial assets. So in the note number 10, other financial assets, we have, this is under the current assets, by the way. And under the current assets, one of the under this note number 10, the first item is interest accrued. Now, are you familiar with the accrual principle of accounting? The accounting is done on accrual basis, and Reliance Industries is saying interest accrued on investment is 147 crores. So there is income that they have earned, but they have not received. So this is not received in cash, but they have earned it. So they will be receiving in the following year. Again, we were not alone, on an island where we discussed about accrual concept and the accrued incomes. The companies actually show all of these, they have to do it. So again, you know the principle. When you see the word accrue, you mean this is something which means it's due, hasn't been received or paid. So, and there are, of course, other items there, but we don't want to go into that because there are a lot of advanced terminology that some of these companies will use. All right, so that was about the asset side of the balance sheet, and looked at some hand-picked items to give you a sense of, so that you can relate to the actual financial statements of the companies as well. On the equities and liabilities side, we used to prepare this, you know, side by side, opposite to each other, T format, account format, but companies show it, you know, one at the top of the other, statement format. So equity share capital, again, note number 13, it says, so as we discussed, this is the money brought in by the shareholders. Let's look at note number 13. In note number 13, this heading says issued, subscribed, and paid up. So paid up capital is the capital brought in by the owners, by the investors. Capital brought in by the shareholders. This is shareholders capital. And they give you number of equity shares, their face value, the money that has been brought in terms of crores. So there you go. Next time you look at this section in the balance sheet, you know what it means. Then I want to go to other equities. This section, other equities, number 14. If you remember, we used to transfer the profit from the profit and loss account to a section called reserve and surpluses. So why do companies show that here? Well, Reliance is showing other equity, and there is a note number 14 here. Here you go. In note number 14, we have something called retained earnings. This is the earning which has not been distributed during the year. After paying all the taxes, all the expenses, this money has been retained, and it is going to contribute to shareholders, you know, funds, the capital in the next year. So if I go back to the equity side here, So the whole equity section includes both of these, equity share capital and the other equity. The other equity, what I'm saying is, this is the section where reserve and surpluses are going to be included. So in a way, it goes back into the company. And in the note, specifically retained earnings, it says profit for the year. This is where the profit for the year is being brought in, being added to the capital. Now, you have a number of other items here, but you know the principle. The principle is, out of the profit, you are going to set aside some amount for certain purposes. And those purposes can vary. Here is a security premium account, debenture redemption reserve, share-based payment reserve, a general reserve which could be used for any purpose. Again, large scale, big companies, they will have different types of reserve for different purposes. We have only discussed retained earnings, which is the profit during the year, being transferred to the equities, to the capital, this fund as a whole. So if you know the principle, you can figure out the rest. You know all this money has been set aside, it's part of the profit, but has been reserved for specific purposes. And they are showing it as other equities. All right, let me go to another note, 22 for current liabilities. So here's the balance sheet. We have looked at the equity, non-current liabilities. I'm not going into this because this is mostly loans and also nothing major that we discussed during the last few videos. But current liabilities, we did discuss about creditors, about short-term loans, overdrafts, trade payables. So let's look at some of these notes and say what are the details that the companies provide. So we are going to other current liabilities. And in the other current liabilities, you have contract liabilities, which means you have contracted with third parties who provide you services and you have to pay to them. So these are the creditors of the business. So creditors of the business. And you have other payables, which are statutory dues, a number of other legal costs that they may have to pay. The note 23, which is provisions. Again, we here the provisions, note 23, under the current liability. We discussed in one of the practice problems that provision needs to be created out of the profit in order to provide for, in order to be ready for any future losses that may happen. So in that case, when you have set aside the profit, you are easy. This is concept, this is principle of conservatism, prepare for losses. So do companies actually do that? Yes, they do. There are provisions that they are creating. Note number 23. So here is note number 23. Provisions under the current liabilities head. What does it mean? Provision for employee benefits. And you have two stars here. Two stars here. There is a description provided. It says the provision is for employee benefit. That includes annual leave, vested long service leave, entitlement accrued, compensation claims made by employees. So companies offer different types of compensations, and they know that on average, X number of employees claim these many benefits, and we will have to be prepared for that. They may or may not claim that, but we have to create a provision for that. So that is what this provision is about. Similarly, there are other provisions. Let us see what these other provisions are. They say the company had recognized liability for excise duty. So these are again, see, uncertain liabilities. And whenever you have some amount of surety, you quickly create a provision so that whenever in future this liability arises, you have money set aside to take care of it. There is no shock. So again, there are other provisions that can be made for different types. Again, I'm emphasizing that the principle, understanding why provisions are created, how they are created, where they are shown, that is important. And now understanding different purposes for which this provision can be created, what is this employee benefit expense, vested long service, all of these things are now to you to further research. If you know what is a vested long service, you know what a provision is, so you'll be able to understand these things more clearly. All right, so in this video, we looked through the balance sheet, both asset side and the liability side, This balance sheet was for Reliance Industries Limited, and we have validated our learning. Whatever we've learned in till now in the process of accounting cycle is actually being done by the companies. So go ahead, download another annual report, another financial statement of any other company, Infosys, TCS, and look at those numbers. Can you read those numbers? I bet you can. You can understand what those numbers mean now. I'll see you in the next video where we look at the income statement of Reliance Industries Limited.